Hello everyone, welcome to the ElliotWave-Forecast.com YouTube channel. My name is Henry. Today is Wednesday, December the 11th, and the time is around 8 a.m. GMT. So today we will be looking at the chart of copper. This is a 60-minute chart. We can see right here, very nice impulsive rally from this low 2.62. We label this with 1 here and this is with 2. That suggests that we are within the wave 3 right now. That should subdivide into a nice 5 waves impulse. Okay, so that means we still like to see more upside, but keep in mind that we are kind of already in the wave 5 now. So I think we only need a few more high here before we end the wave 5. Right, so we need wave 3, 4, 5, and then after that we could be ending the wave 5 in blue and then start to be correcting this entire move here, and this should be ending only a wave 3, okay, in copper. Now if you look at the larger degree, okay, so this is what we're looking for, and this would be ending wave 3 here, and then we can get a bigger pullback before higher again. So we don't really like selling it because it's obviously rallying as an impulse and therefore bullish. If we look at the higher degree now, this is partial view, of course. We can see since November 15 low here, the rally is looking impulsive. So now this is a wave 2 and we are in the wave 3, same as what you see here in the 1 hour chart. So this cycle starts from November 15 low, and you can see clearly separation and very strong move here on the third swing. If you measure the extension, it's actually more than 161.8% extension. That is usually indication of a wave 3, right? So again, soon after a few more high, we should be ending this wave 3, and then after that we should be getting a pullback, right, in the wave 4. So again, we do not like selling it. So what we like then is more upside as far as this pullback later on stays above this wave 2, of course. Now, typically in the Elliott wave principle, in the wave 4, usually is around 23.6, 38.2 retracement, and ideally no more than 50% retracement of the wave 3. So for now, we are still in the process of ending wave 3, but then after wave 3 is finished and we get a decent pullback, then typically we should be ending this wave 4 in some sort of 3 waves, 3-7-11 swing around this area here. Okay, so it depends on where wave 3 is ending. I'm just assuming wave 3 ends here, which is complete assumption here. But assuming wave 3 ends here, then this is approximately the area in which we can expect this wave 4 to finish. And then after that, copper can continue to see more upside. Alright, so we don't like fading the 5 waves move here and looking for further upside. Even in the shorter cycle, we can get a few more high. Then after that, after we finish, we can get a big a pullback in the wave 4, followed by another leg higher again. Alright, so if you enjoyed this video, please do like and subscribe our channel, and I will also provide the link to our service in the description of the video below, so that you can get further updates on other instruments as well. So see you all again tomorrow, and have a nice day everyone.